Hey, I'm Chris Berman. Coming up on ESPN, there's likely no tougher crowd in America to play in front of than a Philly crowd. But this is a city that just loves its Eagles, and they're not afraid to let you know that they'll settle for nothing less than a championship. Eagles, Bears, it's game time.
Still fans making their way through the turnstiles, they'll be just in time to catch the start of this game. Hi, folks, it's Dan Stevens, and welcome to Chicago Field. Peter O'Keefe is next to me in the booth, and Peter, we've got a couple of offensive powerhouses down on the field.
No doubt about it, Dan, we could be in for a high-scoring game today.
Number six is certainly one of the better quarterbacks in this league. His team relies on him to make big plays down the stretch. And nine times out of ten, he does just that.
I'll tell you what, Dan, his teammate isn't too shabby either.
Number 17 is one of the better receivers in the league. He's one of those players that a defense has to key in on and respect. Otherwise, he's going to make you pay.
Deadly combination out there. I'm dying to see how it pans out.
Well, all right, Peter, we'll keep our eye on them as the game progresses. But first, the coin toss.
Heads it is. Number four, kicking off for the Bears.
There's the signal, and we're ready. Number four kicks it, and we are underway. Huff fields it all the way back at the one. Tackled at the 27. Well, it looks like the weather is cooperating with us today, but Susie has the full scoop on that. Susie.
Thank you, Dan. It's a slightly breezy day today, but it probably isn't enough to affect kicks or throws that much. Back to you, guys.
Susie, thank you. The Eagles send their offense out on the field and will start this drive at their own 27-yard line. Houston tackles him behind the line of scrimmage.
Houston targeted the ball carrier early and didn't even let him get back to the line of scrimmage.
They put a stop to this play behind the line of scrimmage. Pretty good call by the defensive coordinator.
Agreed, Dan. They had it all locked up there.
That will bring up second down.
And bunch of receivers out there. Defense is expecting that, and they go to nickel.
Number 11 rifles it out left side, and it's knocked away from the receiver. Incomplete. With the coverage. Third down from the shotgun. This one will fall incomplete. Fourth down coming up.
Number 18 had a chance for a mid-range completion back there, but he just couldn't connect. No catch.
Third and long. They have a chance, but it's incomplete.
Those are the situations where you want someone to step up and make a play.
But no one did, and it will now be fourth down. Number 8 lines up to punt after the three and out. Number 8 takes the snap and punts it away. Royal fields the punt at the 31. Dragged down at the 39.
Royal is one of those wily old vets.
Ninth-year man out of Virginia Tech. He knows the things you can't learn in training camp. Pay attention to this guy.
The Bears will start this drive at their 39-yard line. Royal catches it in the flat and tries to get free. 30, 15, 5, and touchdown.
Royal has just one guy on him, and he beats him easily. Even with my few extra pounds, I think I could have done a better job covering him.
Oh, no. I doubt that. He would have smoked you like a salmon.
That sounds pretty good.
He gets the touchdown, Peter, and that was a very nice play.
Definitely.
Number four to attempt the extra point. Number two, holding.
Here's the point after, and it's good.
Hey, way to go out there. Good shot. Nice play. Nice play.
Number four, kicking off for the Bears.
The ref gets the signal, and we're set. Number four, rockets this one deep. Huff decides to take it out of the end zone. Tackled at the 25.
Huff took it out of the end zone, and while it may have been a little risky, he gets out close to the 20, so it all comes out in the wash on that play.
The Eagles stalled early last drive, and we'll have to wait and see what happens here. They'll start at their own 25-yard line. Number 59 makes the hit in the backfield at
number 59 with the tackle.
Number 59 is relentless here, and he chases the ball carrier into the backfield. He closes in.
There's the hit. You know, that reminds me of this nature show I saw on TV.
Yeah.
Where a lion pounced on an antelope in the Serengeti.
Yeah, but at least the antelope doesn't have to shake hands with the lion when it's all over.
They put a stop to this play behind the line of scrimmage. Pretty good call by the defensive coordinator.
Agreed, Dan. They had it all locked up there.
That will bring up second down. Matthews hauls it in right side and is well past the markers for a first down. Matthews gets the call on first down and takes it upfield.
Matthews is one of those prototypical backs, 6 feet, 220. This guy fits the mold perfectly. Able to dodge defenders with his slick moves and trick maneuvers, he's also strong enough to take them head on.
Second and six. Ball at the Eagles, 45-yard line.
This pass will fall harmlessly to the ground, and it's incomplete. Third down and five wide receivers take the field.
Oh, let's watch this. Five wide out versus a D that is wisely loaded up on DBs.
Number 11 throws this on a rope, and it's tipped. Incomplete. It'll be fourth down.
Number 29 managed to disrupt things. He got in there, and he smacked that pass away. Great D.
It seemed like the defense read that one from the beginning, and they forced the incompletion with relative ease.
Beautiful call by the D coordinator.
It'll be fourth down. Number 8 gets ready to punt this away. Number 8 takes the long snap and punts it away. Royal takes it at the 14. Hammered down at the 20.
Royal got swarmed by the kicking team before he got very far. That nice punt pretty much goes unanswered.
Bears had an effective first drive, and we'll see if they can keep it up. They'll start at their own 20-yard line. Number 33 takes it off the toss and will end up losing a bunch here.
Number 22 keeps his man from getting back to the line. Let's watch. Pow! Oh, that's got to hurt.
The defensive design worked flawlessly, and the refs will spot the ball well behind the original line of scrimmage.
What a way to derail a series from the onset.
Second and long ahead. Second down with the tight end right. Jenkins makes a play on this and forces the incompletion.
Jenkins swatted that one away cleanly. The receiver didn't have a prayer in getting that one.
Third and 14. Ball at the Bears 16-yard line.
Number six zings it to the right side, and the reception is made past the markers for a first down. Royal snags the missile and is well past the markers for a first down.
Royal doesn't let a little thing like double coverage stop him from snagging the football.
A well-designed play there, Peter, and they will move the chains.
And let me tell you, Dan, hearing those chains move is one of the best sounds in the game for an offense.
First down, both tight ends left. White goes in motion. Number 33 will take the handoff and rambles for about five.
Number 98 with the tackle. Second and five.
No one gets through.
Ball at the 47.
Leopard. Hey, I got six. I got six.
Miller mishandles this one and drops it incomplete.
Miller looked like he had a solid catch there, and yet somehow he found a way to drop it.
That would have gotten the first, but it's incomplete, and it will be third down.
Tight D, keep out of range.
Number six throws a lob here, and it is not reeled in. Incomplete.
Miller tried to snag that one across the middle, but doesn't happen.
That will bring up fourth down, and what a disappointment. That would have given them the first.
You've got to make those plays when they come your way.
Number 16 lines up for the punt.
Make the return.
Number 16 gets the snap and punts it away. Number 43 fields the punt at the 12. Stopped at the 16.
Number 43 fielded the ball, and although he was dropped pretty quickly, that terrible kick gives him some good field position.
The Eagles have had some trouble moving the ball recently. We'll see what they do on this drive as they start at their own 16-yard line. Matthews goes in motion. Number 11 throws a heater, and the ball is caught at the 28. Finally dropped at the 32. That will bring up first down.
First and 10. Ball at the Eagles, 32-yard line.
Fuller tips it away on the coverage, incomplete.
Fuller managed to disrupt things. He got in there and he smacked that pass away. Great D.
That had potential for some yards, Peter, but the defense was on top of it and shut it down.
Good denial there.
Second down coming up. Second down, tight end to the left. Number 11 throws a beauty to the right side, and it's tipped, incomplete.
Number 29 swatted that one away cleanly. The receiver didn't have a prayer in getting that one.
That is their fourth batted ball. Tell you, we've seen a number of good defensive plays from this squad.
We sure have. We'll see if they can keep it up, though.
Number 32 puts a lick on the receiver and separates him from the ball. Incomplete. That will bring up fourth down.
Number 32 closed in from the zone and forced the incompletion.
Well, the D holds tight on third and long and forces an incompletion. That was a good call by the defensive coordinator.
Oh, it sure was. Perfect D for that situation.
And it will bring up fourth down. Number 8 gets ready to punt this away. Number 8 gets the ball and punts it away. Royal catches it at the 29. Tackled at the 36.
Royal got swarmed by the kicking team before he got very far. That nice punt pretty much goes unanswered.
The Bears had their last drive stall out at the end. We'll see if they can keep momentum throughout this one, which starts at their 36-yard line. It's intercepted. One man to beat. He's in for the touchdown.
Number 22 picks off the ball, and he's going all the way. Nobody can stop him. Man, I hope his mom's got the VCR going.
Boy, that was a heads-up play to come away with his first interception of the game.
Yeah, you got to love D like that.
Number six to attempt the extra point. Number eight holding.
Now the point after, and it's good.
Number six, kicking off for the Eagles.
The ref gets the signal, and we're set. Number six kicks it off. Number 14 fields the kickoff at the 3. Right down at the 22.
Number 14 tried to run it out, but the defense preferred that he stayed put, and they made their case pretty forcefully there.
The Bears were intercepted last time out. We'll see what happens here. We'll start at their own 22-yard line. Number 33 picks up about 2, and that brings up second down.
Keep your eyes on the pass.
Second and 7. Ball at the Bears' 24-yard line.
Lapper. Single pass. Single back.
Number 95 tackles him behind the line of scrimmage.
Number 95 targeted the ball carrier early and didn't even let him get back to the line of scrimmage.
Nice job eliminating any forward progress on that play. That will bring up a third and long. Miller goes in motion. Number 6 fires this one over the middle, and they get the first on third and long.
Number 11 has some company on this play, but he still makes the catch. That's good concentration and focus. It's worth another look. Oh, maybe they should have triple covered him there.
Third and long, and they get the big play to convert. What do you think of that, Peter?
I love it. That's what football is all about, making the big plays when you need to, and you can't coach that.
First down, one man back. Number 33 gets past the line and rambles for about 5.
Second and 5. Ball of the Bears, 43-yard line.
Number 33 gets the call again and heads left. Tackled at the 49. First down.
Number 33 got yards by staying so close to his blockers. I think they were sharing each other's aftershave.
Nice second down call, and they will move the chain.
On offense, it was always a plus to avoid third down altogether, just like that.
Number 33 carries it for a third time in a row and maybe picks up 1 on the play.
Number 33 used the blocking, but this stingy defense didn't give up much at all on that last play.
Not much there. It'll be second down.
Got to take what you can get, Dan, but they were, you know, hoping for more.
Second down and 4 wideouts in the game. Number 33 takes it for his 8th carry and only gets back to the line of scrimmage.
Number 94 with the tackle. Third and 8. Ball at the 49.
Number 23 makes a play on this one and forces the incompletion. Fourth down coming up.
Number 23 came in and got a hand on that football and left no chance for a reception there.
Well, the knee holds tight on third and long and forces an incompletion. That was a good call by the defensive coordinator.
Oh, it sure was. Perfect D for that situation.
And it will bring up fourth down. Number 16 lines up for the punt. Number 16 gets the snap and punts it away. Number 43 fields the punt at the 11. Stopped at the 19.
Number 43 got swarmed by the kicking team before he got very far. That nice punt pretty much goes unanswered.
The Eagles haven't got much out of their offense recently, and we'll see if they can get back on track here. This drive begins at their own 19-yard line. Huff makes the nice catch and is well past the markers for a first down.
Number 21 finally pushed him out of bounds, but by then the damage was done. He'd given up a ton of yards on that play.
That's his second tackle so far.
They're going air. They're going air.
First and 10. Ball at the Eagles, 38-yard line.
Number 34 goes in motion. Has his number called on first down and chews up about four on the play.
Second and six. Ball at the Eagles, 42-yard line.
It away on the coverage, incomplete.
Number 29 managed to disrupt things. He got in there and he smacked that pass away. Great D.
That's his third batted ball, and he is doing his part, that is for sure.
Nice to see aggressive D like that, Dan.
Third down, 6 yards to go. Number 11 rifles it out left side, and it's tipped, incomplete. It'll be fourth down.
Number 29 swatted that one away cleanly. The receiver didn't have a prayer in getting that one.
You know, as a team, they are batting down passes left and right. That is their sixth so far.
Wow, great anticipation of the pass.
And that'll do it for quarter number one, and we're all tied. Number 8 gets ready to punt this away. Number 8 gets the ball and punts it away. Royal gets it at the 21. Brought down at the 25.
Royal didn't have much room to work with back there. The special team squad made sure he couldn't respond to that really nice punt.
The Bears' offense takes the field, and they will start out at their own 25-yard line. Tackles him behind the line of scrimmage.
That's what I'm talking about, baby.
With the tackle.
I'm bringing it, yeah. I told you.
Number 33 has been searching for a rhythm out there, Dan, and he's coming up short. It seems like his timing is way off. He's working hard, but only has 16 yards on 9 carries.
Second down, one man back.
Ball at the Bears, 25-yard line.
Royal goes in motion. Well, he catches it over the middle and is well past the markers for a first down.
Number 6 gets it past 2 defenders on this one. What a throw. It's worth a second look. That's what you call confidence. Throwing into double coverage like that, and what accuracy to boot.
What a pass, and he is generating some great numbers.
Oh, absolutely, Dan. So far, he's got 125 yards and 1 touchdown.
Number 6 zips it to the left sideline, and it got away from him a bit. Incomplete.
Number 98 did a beautiful job on that last play covering the post route. That pass never had a chance. Incomplete.
Potential for some nice yards, but the defense plays it tough. That will bring up second down.
Single back, single back.
Intercepted. Tackled at the 46.
Number six is feeling some pressure as he lets this one go, which is why it zings right into the defender's reach. He wishes he had that one back.
That's his second interception throw today, and he has looked ragged at some points, I'll tell you.
Yeah, his timing's a little off. He needs to just settle it down.
The Eagles are going to try and capitalize on the interception. They'll start this drive at the 46-yard line. Matthew gets the ball and gains about 3 yards.
Okay, fellas, we've been over this all week in practice. Now we're going to get it this time. Now we're going to go just like it is. We're going to execute, and we're going to stay strong, and we're going to get to the spot we need to. Okay, fellas?
Watch the pass! Second and six.
Ball at the 43.
Matthews catches the bullet out left and gets past the markers for a first down.
First down, Eagles.
Number 11 gets it past the defender and into the arms of his receiver. That's a great play. Check it out. Ooh, nice, accurate throw.
A well-designed play there, Peter, and they will move the chain.
Great execution.
Ball at the 33.
Number 11 throws a bullet, and the reception is made for a pickup of maybe a yard.
Yeah, baby. Woo.
Yeah, baby. Yeah.
Second down, two wideouts on the field.
Ball at the 33.
Single down, single back.
Number 34 didn't haul that one in, and it falls incomplete.
Number 34 staked out some turf in the middle back there, but was not able to reel in the catch. Incompletion.
If complete, that would have made for a bit shorter third down play, but not much.
Not a lot of potential on that call.
Number 87 goes in motion. Number 11 really rifles this pass, and it's complete for a first down and a whole lot more.
Number 18 shooters his man on the finer points of coverage on this play.
A nice catch, but also a nice move to shake the coverage.
He owned that matchup.
That's broken kind of a cold streak for him. The last two passes his way were incomplete.
Yeah, let's see if he stays on track.
It's intercepted.
Check out the interception here on the replay, Dan. Watch how he reacts to get in the ball's path. Nice. That's how you make the INT, baby.
Boy, that was a heads-up play to come away with his first interception of the game.
Yeah, you gotta love D like that.
The Bears get their offense on the field and will start this drive at their own 20-yard line. Number 33 is at the 35, hunted down at the 37. It will be first down.
Look at this run, Dan. Everything worked out to perfection. Look at the fluidity of the running style. There's no wasted motion there. What a play.
A well-designed play there, Peter, and they will move the chains.
And let me tell you, Dan, hearing those chains move is one of the best sounds in the game for an offense.
Number 98 sacks him back at the 34.
Number 98 got the sack, but he was totally unblocked. You need to at least lay a hand on someone to slow him down a bit.
They put a stop to this play behind the line of scrimmage. Pretty good call by the defensive coordinator.
Agreed, Dan. They had it all locked up there.
That will bring up second down. Number six rifles it out left side, and the reception is made for a pickup of maybe a yard.
Number six had no trouble zinging that one past the secondary. That was one heck of a throw.
And I'll tell you what, this looks like it wasn't that difficult to tackle, but he had his hands full.
Yeah, looks can be deceiving, Dan. He really had to square himself perfectly to make that play.
Number 17 makes the catch out to the left, and they get the first on third and long.
Number 33 looked to be in perfect position to make that catch, but it didn't come together somehow.
With the coverage. Second and 10. Ball at the 42-yard line.
Number 33 will get stopped at the line, and that will bring up third down.
Jenkins was a one-man wrecking crew back there. He powered into the backfield and made the tackle.
That's his third tackle of the game. Third down, and this is the seventh play of the drive. Number 6 unloads this one to the left, and it's intercepted. Brought down at the 37.
Number 23 knows he doesn't have a shot at it unless he jumps for it. And man, he timed it perfectly. Could give his receivers a few tips about mid-air receptions.
Peter, you couldn't ask for more from him today. He has done his part.
And then some. So far, he's got two interceptions.
The Eagles had their last drive stall out at the end. We'll see if they can keep momentum throughout this one, which starts at the 37-yard line. Matthew carries it for the sixth time and gains about 3 yards.
Okay, what's the plan? Okay, let's go.
Second and 7. Ball at the Eagles, 40-yard line.
Number 11 zings it to the right side, and the reception is made past the markers for a first down.
First down, Eagles.
Huff had three guys covering him, but look what happens. Incredible catch.
Peter, I'm sure he's happy to bring that one in. The last three passes to him have all been incompletion.
Yeah, he's struggling a bit there, but this may turn him around.
First down, two tight ends in the game. Matthews makes the catch on the right sideline, and that's good for a gain of 5.
Matthews nabbed the pass without any challenge whatsoever from the defense. When you're that open, every quarterback in the league can get it to you.
They move the ball, and it will be second down. Matthews gets the toss and runs into traffic. Dragged down at the 45.
Matthews just hasn't gotten into a groove and isn't finding running room anywhere. This has been tough, and he struggled to get 12 yards on 7 carries.
Hey, baby, won't send that quarterback to the bench.
Ball at the 45.
No, down.
Number 17 grabs the fastball over the middle, and they convert on third down.
Number 17 plays this one perfectly, getting himself to the right place at the right time to make the catch. The defense should be embarrassed that they let this one get away.
Yeah, Peter, they had him double covered, and they still couldn't get to the ball in time. He was just too good for them.
Yeah, he's an incredible receiver. Nothing gets in his way.
A nice game, and they easily convert on third down.
Yeah, that was a good call.
Number 11 zips it to the left sideline, and it's tipped. Incomplete.
Fuller got himself in prime position to bat away that football before the receiver even had a shot at it.
A nice defensive play will give him his second batted ball of the game.
Yeah, great read there.
Matthews goes in motion. Matthews takes it for his 8th carry and gains about 3 yards.
This is the series here, baby. We got to stop it.
Number 11 just rifles this one, and it's tipped. Incomplete. That will bring up fourth down.
Number 29 came in and got a hand on that football and left no chance for a reception there.
He records yet another batted ball, and I'll tell you, he's really playing well out there.
Yeah, he's been after the ball from the beginning of the game. Real aggressive play.
Fourth down, and the field goal unit is on the field. number six, with the 45-yard attempt, and they take the lead.
Number six, knocks through a good-sized kick. Watch here. Nowhere close to his max, but he's obviously still very pleased to pull it off.
Number six, kicking off for the Eagles.
There's the signal, and we're ready. Number six, booms a beauty here. Royal decides to take it out of the end zone. Tackled at the 25. Well, Peter, some interesting information up on the screen.
Oh, you bet. How they turn the ball over leaps out at me, and you have to think that that could come back to haunt them. Turnovers are the most telling stat in the NFL.
Royal
got out close to the 20 on that one, so his decision to take it out of the end zone didn't really pay off, but it didn't really hurt him either.
The Bears have turned the ball over the past two times out. They need to hold on to it as they start this drive at their own 25-yard line. Number 33 gains five on the play, and that will bring up second down. Second down with the tight end right. Number 17 goes in motion. Number 33 dodges this one way out right and gains about 3 yards. Third down, just a single receiver on the field. Number 33 will get the carry on third down and gets tackled short of the markers. That will bring up fourth down.
Graham targeted the ball carrier early and didn't even let him get back to the line of scrimmage.
That's his second tackle so far. Number 16 lines up to punt after the three and out. Number 16 takes the long snap and punts it away. Number 43 fields the punt at the 26. Stopped at the 38.
Number 43 did a nice job getting some yards after fielding the solid punt.
The Eagles are looking for some separation before half and will start this drive at their 38-yard line. Matthew will get the carry on first down and heads out right. Tackled, and the clock will continue to run.
Number 38 with the tackle.
Watch the pass.
Second and six.
Watch the throw.
Ball at the Eagles, 42-yard line.
Number 11 unloads this to the right sideline, and it's intercepted.
Number 21 shows why you think twice before throwing a pass in his neighborhood. Watch. Great presence of mind to try for the football there.
Well, that's their second interception of the game, and stingy is appearing to be the motto for their defense.
Yeah, either that or give me the ball.
The Bears offense comes out and has an opportunity to tie it before halftime. They'll start at their 44-yard line. No good, incomplete.
With the deflection.
Okay, guys, we've covered this before. You know the plan. You know what to do. Let's stick to the plan.
Spread, spread.
Second and 10.
Lucy.
Ball at the Bears, 44-yard line.
I got 17. I got 13.
Number six rifles this one hard over the middle, and it's tipped. Incomplete.
Greg Brooks came in and got a hand on that football and left no chance for a reception there.
That is their fourth batted ball. Tell you, we've seen a number of good defensive plays from this squad.
We sure have. We'll see if they can keep it up, though.
Third down and five wide receivers take the field. White pitches it in the flat, and he's well short of the markers. It'll be fourth down.
White ran out of bounds there, well short of where he wanted to go.
They get some yards out of that play, but they are short.
Yeah, didn't get quite the punch they wanted to.
It'll be fourth down. Number 16 lines up for the punt. Number 16 takes the snap and punts it away. Number 43 fields it at the 15. Stopped at the 18.
Number 43 got swarmed by the kicking team before he got very far. That nice punt pretty much goes unanswered.
The Eagles offense takes the field with the clock at 18. Fuller tips it away on the coverage, incomplete.
Fuller came in and got a hand on that football and left no chance for a reception there.
Another batted ball, and they have been attacking the pass every chance they get.
That's right, Dan. You know, why simply defend the pass when you can obliterate it?
Huff goes in motion. Number 11 zings it to the right side, and it's tipped, incomplete.
Number 21 came in and got a hand on that football and left no chance for a reception there.
On second down, they try for the first, but it's played well by the defense. That will bring up third down.
Nice pressure that time.
Third down, 10 yards to go. Grabs the rope right side, and they get the first on third and long. And that'll do it for the first half of this one. The Eagles with a small lead, 10-7. And now let's send you to Chris Berman in our studios in Bristol for the ESPN Halftime Report. Boomer?
All right, Dan, we'll get back to you in a bit. But welcome, everybody, to the ESPN Halftime Show. I'm Chris Berman. The Bears, therefore, find themselves in a tight ballgame. Anything can happen in the second half. Let's get started in this one early in the first quarter. Number 19 emerged as a real weapon as he pulled one in here. A 61-yard touchdown for the Bears. The Bears strike first and go up by 7. Eagles still early in the first. Number 11 connected with his man on this one. Dub Bears early in the first quarter. Bears leading by 7. Number 6 would find his target on this one. Eagles midway through the first. Number 11 would drop back and deliver a strike on this one. Eagles trailing 7-0. Number 22 would come up with a huge play here as he was able to pick one off here, then had some clear sailing in front of him. Touchdown for the Eagles. The Eagles even the score 7-all. Eagles end of the first quarter. Number 11 would find his target on this one. Dub Bears later on in the second quarter. Game tied 7-all. Number 23 is reading the quarterback's eyes all the way as he's able to get his hands on this one and pick it off. Eagles still early in the second quarter. Number 29 would come up with the big play to kill a drive as he was able to step in front of a wayward pass for an INT. Game tied 7-all. Number 23 is reading the quarterback's eyes all the way as he's able to get his hands on this one and pick it off. After driving 35 yards on 8 plays, number 6 comes on for the field goal try. Good spot. This is right through the upright. Connect on the field goal. Eagles late into the second quarter. Eagles winning by 3. Number 21 was in the right place at the right time as his interception was a possible momentum shifter. Eagles creeping up on the end of the half. Number 11 connected with his man on this one. And that's where we'll leave this one. Bears are down, but still in it, 10-7. And as far as my halftime hero, well, there's really no contest. Number 19 has taken over this game. So that'll do it from here. Let's send you back out now to Dan Stevens and Peter O'Keefe. Dan?
Thanks, Chris. And today's game has been presented in ESPN Game Sound, designed and developed in collaboration with Dolby, the leader in surround sound technology. The Bears will receive to start the second half, and this is a tight contest. Currently, they're down 10-7. Now, let's get to the game. Number 6 boots the second half kickoff away. Number 14 decides to take it out of the end zone. Tackled at the 26. Susie Culver is down on the field and has some information for us. Susie?
Thanks, Dan. Head coach Lovie Smith talked with us just a second ago, and he mentioned that while it's a close game, he is not at all happy in the turnover department. He added, it's the kind of game where every possession counts, and you simply can't give up the ball like we have. We'll have to wait and see what happens. Back to you.
Thanks, Susie. Number 33 takes the handoff and rambles for about 5.
Second and 5. Run. Ball at the Bears' 31-yard line.
Number 6 throws a big rainbow here, and they can't connect. Incomplete.
Brooks shadowed the slant route back there and kept the receiver from making the catch. Incomplete pass.
Third down, 3 wideouts in the game.
Ball of the Bears, 31-yard line.
Motion.
Number 17 catches the hard throw, and they get the first on third and long.
Number 6 zings this one perfectly. Great pass, great catch, great play. Let's have another look. Bullseye. What a precise throw. They keep doing plays like this, they could be in big trouble.
That's another pass that went pretty much down the middle. He hasn't been working the sides too much.
Well, he's obviously very confident to be throwing into where all the traffic is. He's daring the D to stop him.
Number 6 puts his arm into this one, and it's tipped. Incomplete.
Number 6 has found limited success in the passing game so far, Dan, and he just can't seem to get into a rhythm out there. I'd say he's not very pleased with his performance. So far, he's got 172 yards and 3 interceptions.
Number 17 goes in motion. Number 33 will get the carry on second down and maybe picks up 1 on the play.
Number 33 had some blocking help on that last one, but he was still left with nowhere to go.
Well, not much of a game there, and they will face third down.
Third and long, too, Dan. Big play coming up.
Third down from the shotgun. Number 6 sifts it to the left sideline, and they get the first on third and long.
Number 6 uncorks a dynamite pass there with 2 defenders on the prowl.
Really incredible accuracy, but I'll tell you, that's got a sting if you're on the defense.
Righto, Dano. You know, they could have brought 8 guys on that play. Wouldn't have made a difference.
Again, a nice medium pass. He's been concentrating on those connections a lot today.
Yeah, it's a nice range. Get you some good yards, but it's not so far out that you're not in total control of the situation.
Number 33 takes it for his 17th carry and gains about 3 yards.
Second and 7. Ball at the 35.
Number 33 gains 5 on the play, and that brings up third down. Third down, 1 man back.
Ball at the 30-yard line.
Number 17 didn't haul that one in, and it falls incomplete. Fourth down coming up.
Greg Brooks had superb coverage on that play. No wonder it was incomplete.
That was a fantastic job by the defense to stop what would have been a first down.
I love to see Big D on third and short situations. Fourth down, defenses love to hear that from the refs.
It's good!
Number 4 really gets the whole ball here, and he needed it. Watch. That's a powerful kick for 3 points, my friend. When he needs to, he can boot that thing.
Number four, kicking off for the Bears.
The ref gets the signal, and we're set. Number four, booms a beauty here. Huff decides to take it out of the end zone. Brought down at the 22. Well, Peter, some interesting information up on the screen.
Oh, you bet. Look at how many times they've had to punt it away. They've got to put a few longer drives together and get into the end zone. Huff took it out of the end zone, and while it may have been a little risky, he gets out close to the 20, so it all comes out in the wash on that play.
The Eagles bring their offense on the field and will start this drive at their own 22-yard line. Number 11 throws a beauty to the right side, and it's knocked away from the receiver, incomplete.
Holden did a brilliant job keeping watch over his zone. That pass didn't have a chance.
That had potential for some yards, Peter, but the defense was on top of it and shut it down.
Good denial there.
Second down coming up. Number 50 tips it away on the coverage, incomplete.
Number 50 swatted that one away cleanly. The receiver didn't have a prayer in getting that one.
On second down, they try for the first, but it's played well by the defense. That will bring up third down.
Nice pressure that time.
Number 11 fires this one over the middle, and it's complete for a first down and a whole lot more.
Number 18 made the catch back there, but then worked for a few extra yards on top of that. Great effort.
That's broken kind of a cold streak for him. The last two passes his way were incomplete.
Yeah, let's see if he stays on track.
First down, two wideouts on the field. Number 34 goes in motion. Picks up six on the play, and that will bring up second down.
Second and four. Ball to 49.
Matthews takes this one way out left and picks up a couple.
Number 50 with the tackle.
Keep my field goal ready.
Third and one. Ball at the 47.
Matthew carries it for a third time in a row and picks up the first down.
Bringing it all day.
First down, Eagles.
First down, and this is the seventh play of the drive. Number 11 uncorks this to the left sideline, and it's off, incomplete.
Was the intended receiver? Fuller with the cover.
Fuller is sitting back there in the zone waiting for this one, Dan. Check it out. Yep, he forced the incomplete pass. That's great coverage.
Second and 10. Ball at the 42-yard line.
No dice, and it falls incomplete.
Matthews found a spot in the middle on that last play, but couldn't connect with the ball. No catch.
Another ball comes his way, and another incompletion. To come up blank so many times in a row is, well, it's got to be demoralizing for a player.
Absolutely, but you got to fight through the slump and grab one to get rolling again.
Number 11 rifles it out left side, and it falls incomplete. Number 8 lines up for the punt. Number 8 gets the ball and punts it away. The Bears let this one bounce, but it will pin them deep at the 8.
Number 8 angles this one nicely and puts it out of bounds and away from any potential return inside the 10. That's a nice punt.
The Bears' offense takes the field, and they have a way to go. They'll start at their own 9-yard line. Number 33 gains 5 on the play, and that brings up second down.
Second and 4. Ball at the Bears' 14-yard line.
Number 17 goes in motion. They couldn't connect on this one. Incomplete.
Number 17 muffed an almost guaranteed catch there. And as a receiver, you have to carry your weight and make the play. They don't come much more catchable than that one.
That's his first drop of the game. And while every drop does hurt, you can't throw too much blame on him for that one.
That would have been a tough catch.
Third down and 4 wideouts in the game. Number 6 just rifles this one, and they convert on third down. Number 33 gets the call on first down and heads upfield. Brought down hard at the 37. That will bring up first down.
Nice gain on this baby. Look at him eat up the yardage here.
A well-designed play there, Peter, and they will move the chains.
And let me tell you, Dan, hearing those chains move is one of the best sounds in the game for an offense.
Number 6 throws a bullet to the flat, and the reception is made past the markers for a first down.
Number 17 throws to the outside here and picks up some good yardage. It's worth a second look. Nice gain, past the marker and out of bounds. That's a great play. Oh, wow. Look at the yardage racked up through the air.
Number 33 goes in motion. Jenkins makes a play on this and forces the incompletion.
Jenkins managed to disrupt things. He got in there and he smacked that pass away. Great D.
That's his third batted ball. And he is doing his part, that is for sure.
Nice to see aggressive D like that, Dan.
Number 33 gets the handoff and heads out right. Tackled at the 47.
Number 98 with the tackle. Third and 6. Ball at the 47.
Royal didn't haul that one in, and it falls incomplete. It'll be fourth down.
Royal had some room on the fringes there, but couldn't reel in the pass.
Peter, in third down situations, they have not been successful at all with the pass. This play was more proof.
Boy, third is such a crucial down, Dan. And when you don't convert, it really hurts.
Number 16 gets the snap and punts it away. Number 43, fair catches it at the 13.
Fair catch interference. Number 31, offense. 15-yard penalty from the spot of the foul.
Number 31 made contact on that play after a fair catch signal was clearly made, so he got the call for interference. You just can't do that.
The Eagles' offense will start this drive at their own 28-yard line. Huff goes in motion. Number 50 tackles him behind the line of scrimmage.
Number 50 targeted the ball carrier early and didn't even let him get back to the line of scrimmage.
Another tackle, and he's starting to fill up the stat book.
He is dominating, Dan. So far, he's got 5 tackles.
Number 11 rifles it out left side, and the ball is caught for a gain of 7 on the play.
Number 17 was getting double coverage there, but it wasn't enough to stop him from making the catch.
The balls are coming his way in the middle, and he's making them pay. You have to like his performance so far.
Well, Dan, I like any receiver who's willing to go over the middle and sacrifice the body to make the catch.
Third down from the eye. Huff catches this one, and you can't slalom around him like a downhill skier would, Peter. He's going to swallow you up.
Yeah, got to be a cross-country skier that time to get around him. He is a load out there.
Coach Reed is not happy with that call, and he's going to challenge it.
We want a challenge.
Philadelphia is challenging the spot of the ball.
This is their first challenge of the game, and even if they lose this one, they still have one challenge left.
As we watch the replay here, look for where the ball is when he's tackled. Remember, all he needs is one knee to be down.
After review, the call on the field is overturned. Philadelphia will not be charged with timeout. Fourth down.
There's the reaction, and that's what you would expect from someone who won the challenge but ended up being worse off because of it. Number 8 gets ready to punt this away.
Number 19 to make the return.
Number 8 takes the snap and punts it away. Royal fields the punt at the 21. Dragged down at the 25.
Royal got swarmed by the kicking team before he got very far. That nice punt pretty much goes unanswered.
The Bears had their last drive stall out at the end. We'll see if they can keep momentum throughout this one, which starts at their own 25-yard line. Number 87 goes in motion. Number 33 will take this one off the toss and chews up about 4 on the play.
Look at the numbers generated on the ground. That is impressive.
Number 33 has his number called on second down and gains about 3 yards.
Number 23 with the tackle.
Lock him down, lock
Third
him down.
Third and 2. All of the Bears 32-yard line.
Number 6 zings it to the right side, and it's intercepted.
Dan, this is a nice interception. Check his position out to make the grab. Got it.
Yet another interception for this defense, and they're making passing just about impossible so far.
Absolutely. Great reads, great jumps on the ball, great athletes. It's all happening down there.
The Eagles start this drive in great field position at the 41-yard line. Matthew will get the carry on first down and chews up about 4 on the play. So, 3 quarters in the books now, and we're all tied. Second down, 6 yards to go. Matthews carries it for the 15th time and gains about 3 yards.
Houston with the tackle.
Wow, look at those tackles. That's how you play sideline to sideline.
Matthews goes in motion. Number 38 makes a play on this and forces the incompletion. That will bring up fourth down.
Number 38 came in and got a hand on that football and left no chance for a reception there.
Another batted ball, and they have been attacking the pass every chance they get.
That's right, Dan. You know, why simply defend the pass when you can obliterate it?
Number 8 takes the long snap and kicks what will be a short one. Royal fair catches it at the 12. The Bears stalled early last drive and will have to wait and see what happens here. They'll start at their own 13-yard line. This pass will fall harmlessly to the ground and it's incomplete.
Jenkins did a tremendous job on that last play, guarding against the post pattern. That pass went incomplete.
Potential for some nice yards, but the defense plays it tough. That will bring up second down. Number 6 floats it to the right side and it's intercepted.
I'm coming.
Well, it's all about getting in position to make the grab, and watch here. Oh, that's perfect position.
Another interception for his stats today, and I tell you, I can't remember when I've seen a defensive performance like this.
This guy's rewriting history.
The Eagles have an extremely short field ahead of them as they will start this drive at the 19-yard line. Intercepted. Brought down at the 13.
Number 29 took the football back for a little gain after he picked it off. He was hoping for more, but, you know, he'll take it.
That's their third interception of the game. And, Peter, the D is homing in on the passing game.
Yeah, tough play. I love it.
The Bears have had some trouble moving the ball recently. We'll see what they do on this drive as they start at their own 13-yard line. Number 6 lobs this one way over the middle and it's complete for a first down and a whole lot more.
Number 6 gets it past the defender and into the arms of his receiver. That's a great play. Check it out. Ooh, nice, accurate throw.
Again, a nice medium pass. He's been concentrating on those connections a lot today.
Yeah, it's a nice range. Gets you some good yards, but it's not so far out that you're not in total control of the situation.
White goes in motion. Royal didn't haul that one in, and it falls incomplete.
Number 22 shadowed the slant route back there and kept the receiver from making the catch. Incomplete pass.
Second and 10. Ball of the Bears, 34 yards.
Hey, I got 17. I got 19.
Slides down at the 40.
Number 6 decided at the last moment to scramble back there, and it worked out.
Third down, 3 wideouts in the game. Curry knocks it down at the line, incomplete. Fourth down coming up.
Curry moved quick to bat that one down at the line. Good reaction time.
Number 16 gets ready to punt this away.
Number 43 to make the return.
Number 16 gets the ball and punts it away. Number 43 takes it at the 20. Stopped at the 32.
Number 43 did a nice job getting some yards after fielding the solid punt.
The Eagles were intercepted last time out. We'll see what happens here. We'll start at their 32-yard line. This one will fall incomplete.
Matthew was the intended receiver.
Number 11. He's really struggling out there today. As you can see by the numbers, it's all bad. Up to now, he's got 161 yards and 3 interceptions.
Second down, 2 receivers to the left. Number 11 fires this one over the middle, and the reception is made past the markers for a first down.
First and 10. Ball at the Eagles, 44-yard line.
Matthew barrels off his left guard and rambles for about 5.
Here comes the screen. Here comes
second
the screen.
And 5. Ball at the Eagles, 49-yard line.
Matthew gets the call again and heads left. Tackled at the 46. It will be first down.
First down, Eagles.
Matthews has been taking it both outside and inside the tackles, but the D is not letting him get too free. So far, he's had to work hard to get 49 yards on 17 carries.
First down with a split backfield.
Ball at the 46-yard line.
It over the middle and as well past the markers for a first down.
Huff is matched up well with the defense on this one, but is able to stay one step ahead for the completion. It's worth another look here. Oh yeah, the D might want to put more men on him next time.
I'm glad he finally nabbed one, because he's had a string of missed catches before this.
Yeah, his quarterback obviously didn't lose faith in him, though, Dan, because he's kept throwing it his way.
Number 11 lobs this one over the middle, and it is not reeled in. Incomplete.
Number 29 closed in from the zone and forced the incompletion.
Potential for some nice yards, but the defense plays it tough. That will bring up second down. Matthews hauls it in right side, and he gets the go-ahead touchdown.
Matthews faces double coverage on this play, but still comes out with the ball. Nice throw and nice catch. Let's take a look. They had him covered well, but he was still able to make the catch. That guy's a great receiver.
They take the lead on that touchdown, Peter, and they have to be happy with their performance on that drive.
Yeah, great calls and great execution.
Now the point after, and it's good.
Number 6, kicking off for the Eagles.
There's the signal, and we're ready. Number 6 rockets this one deep. Royal decides to take it out of the end zone. Dragged down at the 23.
Royal took it out of the end zone, and while it may have been a little risky, he gets out close to the 20, so it all comes out in the wash on that play.
The Bears haven't got much out of their offense recently, and we'll see if they can get back on track here. This drive begins at their own 23-yard line. Number 6 throws a bullet, and the ball is caught at the 26. tackled at the 31.
Number six zeroed in with the pass back there and leaves the two defenders empty-handed. What ball placement.
Peter, what a nice pickup to get them into a second and short situation.
Yeah, great play, and now they have a bunch of options on what to try next.
Miller goes in motion. Number 33 gets the handoff and maybe picks up one on the play.
Number 33 got some help on that one in the form of blocking, but he still couldn't make a play out of it.
Not much there, but they'll get another shot on third and short. Number 33 picked up about seven, and they will move the chains.
Number 33 played it smart back there by following his blockers, and that allowed him to make some good yards.
A big gain on third, and they will easily move the chain.
Perfect call for the situation, Dan. No trouble in getting the first.
White catches the bullet out left and is well past the markers for a first down.
White has some company on this play, but he still makes the catch. That's good concentration and focus. It's worth another look. Oh, maybe they should have triple covered him there.
That's another medium range catch for him. He's really found his niche in there.
Yeah, and unless he starts getting shut down, there's no reason for him to move out of it.
First down, both wideouts to the right. Logan gets the sack at the 47.
Logan gets a sack in the backfield. The quarterback had nowhere to go on this one. Let's watch. Yep, the D shut the offense down on that play. They couldn't do anything.
That'll be his first sack of the game. Number 17 goes in motion. Number 98 makes the sack just behind the line.
The Eagles drop the quarterback with just three linemen. Guess bad things do come in threes after all.
That will be two losses in a row.
Great reads by the D on the last two plays, Dan. Ball at the 47.
Number six makes the long, long pass, and it's off, incomplete.
Pass interference, number 29, defense. The ball is placed at the spot of the foul. Automatic first down.
Number 29 draws a flag here from some aggressive coverage. You can't be that physical with a receiver and get away with it. Yeah, that's pass interference, all right. Good call.
First down, one man back.
Ball at the 22-yard line.
Single back! Single back! I got 13.
Aina,
I got 13.
Red, 56.
I got 17.
Aina, red, 56.
Number 17 didn't haul that one in, and it falls incomplete.
Number 17 executed a nice little hook on that last one, but he couldn't bring the ball in. Incomplete.
Another ball comes his way, and another incompletion. To come up blank so many times in a row is, well, it's got to be demoralizing for a player.
Absolutely, but you got to fight through the slump and grab one to get rolling again.
Number 17 goes in motion. Number six airs this one to the left sideline, and it's incomplete.
Royal had that ball in his hands on that play, and then he just dropped it.
Peter, oh, I tell you, he seems to be in a bit of a funk recently. Yeah, I mean, you know, that's his fourth ball thrown his way, and he can't reel them in.
Yeah, funky, Dan. He's just got to grab one to get his confidence back, though.
Number 11 grabs the fastball over the middle, and he will be short of the markers. It'll be fourth down.
Number 29 shut down the ball carrier just before he got to the markers. A good game, but not good enough.
That's his second tackle so far. Number four kicks it from 33 yards. It's good.
Number four has no problem getting this one between the sticks for three. Oh, he was so close. He could have made that if he was wearing wooden clogs.
Well, unfortunately, I have a feeling we'll never know for sure. They're setting up for the onside kick. Number four bounces it up. Number 42 gathers it up at the 43. Dragged down at the 43.
Number 42 wasn't going to let a miracle happen on this onside. It comes his way and then gets his hands around it to put the offense out on the field. Great work by this hands team.
They can't bring down the onside kick. Pretty aggressive play calling there, though.
Well, the offense is like a 1-in-4 chance of recovering those, but they knew the risks.
Burton goes in motion. Picks up about two, and that will bring up second down.
Matthews powered forward with the football thanks to some initial blocking. Problem was they couldn't keep that push going for very long.
Not much there. It'll be second down.
Got to take what you can get, Dan, but they were, you know, hoping for more.
Second down, two tight ends in the game. Matthews gets the call on second down and searches for a hole. Ground to a halt at the 40.
Matthews used the blocking, but this stingy defense didn't give up much at all on that last play.
Well, not much of a game there, and they will face third down.
Third and long, too, Dan. Big play coming up.
Third down, 7 yards to go. Punches this one left of center, and the Bears take their first timeout. Timeout. That's their second. First down, just a single receiver on the field. The Bears take a timeout. That's their final one. Second down. The clock is stopped at 1:46. Matthew chews up 4 yards, and the clock will continue to run.
That brings up third down, and it also will take another chunk of time off the clock.
Third down, both tight ends left.
Well, this is where the offense goes in slow motion. No hurry to start the play. Use up as much time as possible.
Matthews has his number called on third down and is brought down short of the markers. The clock is still running. Fourth down coming up.
Dan, I want to point out something on that last play. Did you notice the job he did in letting the play clock wind all the way down before snapping the ball? That's good clock management.
Fourth down, and the field goal unit is on the field. Number six kicks from 39 yards out, and it's good.
Number six knocks through a good-sized kick. Watch here. Nowhere close to his max, but he's obviously still very pleased to pull it off.
Number six, kicking off for the Eagles.
There's the signal, and we're ready. Number six kicks this one away. Number 14 catches it back at the 3. Tackled at the 32.
Number 14 got a very respectable return off that nice kickoff there, Dan.
The Bears start this drive of the game from well in their own territory, and the clock at 33. Intercepted. The ball's loose. Touchdown at the 38.
Number 95 does a fantastic job breaking down the play and knowing where to be to intercept the pass. Having help in the zone really paid off for him.
Peter, he gets his first forced fumble of the day, and it seemed to me that he was looking for that since the first snap.
Yeah, he's been going for the ball all day, and well, it's really paid off. Not a lot of time to get the job done, but they can stop the clock 3 times with their timeouts. A loss of yards here, but they aren't too concerned about that. They just want to keep that clock moving.
And that will do it for tonight's game. The Eagles come out on top 20-13. For my partner, Peter O'Keefe, this is Dan Stevens saying goodbye until next time.
All right, Dan, thank you. So this one is in the books as we welcome you all to our ESPN Video Games post-game show. I'm Chris Berman. The Eagles stepped it up for sure, putting up some good numbers. Let's get started in this one early in the third quarter. After driving 44 yards on 9 plays, number 4 sets up the field goal attempt from just about the parking lot. Got a lot of leg, though. He's got it! A 48-yard field goal. The Bears again tie it up 10-all. Number 11 would drop back and deliver a strike on this one. Game tied 10-all. Jenkins shows some great awareness here as he gets himself into position to pick this one off. The Bears again have it. Number 23 was in the right place at the right time as his interception was a possible momentum shifter. Game tied 10-all. Number 29 is reading the quarterback's eyes all the way as he's able to get his hands on this one and pick it off. The Bears have it off an interception. Number 6 would find his target on this one. Game tied 10-all. Number 11 connected with his man on this one. The Bears come right back. Number 6 would drop back and deliver a strike on this one. That set up a 34-yard field goal. Bears down 17-13. After driving 21 yards on 7 plays, number 6 would come on and connect on the field goal try. A 39-yard field goal. The Bears on D, number 23, would snuff out a drive on this one. It's a fumble. Here he is for the recovery. And that's where we'll leave this one. Eagles squeaked out a win, 20-13. Now let's take a sec to chat with our player of the game, the guy who seemed to be all over the field on defense and came up with big play after big play. Number 23 is on hand with Susie Culber. Suze?
Thanks, Chris. You really showed up today. You may have the ingredient your team needed to pull out a win here. What was the key to your success?
Man, I think that our linebackers are the spark plugs of the whole team. Nobody wants to win more than those guys, and they put their bodies on the line every down for the good of the team. And they should get a lot of credit for this win.
Chris, back to you.
That winds up our broadcast of the NFL preseason on ESPN, the worldwide leader in sports for 25 years and counting. I'm Chris Berman. Thanks for joining us.